I live where there's no TV, there's no radio, there's no clocks, there's no electric lights. The girls carry water. They don't wear makeup. They have their babies by themselves. They go in the shack and squat down and have their babies. I live on the ground. I live on the earth. I lived in Hollywood, and I had all that. The Rolls Royce and the Ferrari and the pad in Beverly Hills. I had the surfboard and the Beach Boys and the Whiskey Q and Neil Diamond and the Ross Cobb and the Jimmy Fiffins and Elvis Presley and Lester Bestley and all them guys. The Dina Martins and the Nancy Sinatras and the Scott Sinatra. And when you do it to me, I hear you do it good, honey, and all that kind of thing. You come up to my house later. So I went through all that, and I seen that was a bigger prison than the one I just got out of, and I really didn't care to go back to prison. And prison doesn't begin and end at the gate. Prison is in the mind. It's locked in one world that's dead and dying, or it's open to a world that's free and alive. Drugs, LSD, I don't consider a drug. I don't consider powdery drugs. Those are more or less religiously significant awareness, mind-expanding apparatuses that come from the intelligence of the universe. The reason that the girls liked me was, hey now, I'm all around you, hey now, up on your heart I can see through you. And I play, and I sing, and they say, hey, man, you got soul in that music. And I said, yeah, I play a little bit, you know. I like music. And they said, man, you're really somebody. I said, oh, I am? Oh, I just got out of jail. I don't know what somebody is. They like my music. They say, man, we want to get you over. I said, get me over for what? They said, we take you down here to Beverly Hills, and we want to get you in because you're a star. I said, I'm a what? That you're a star. So they took me to the Beach Boys, and I went and I got on the surfboard and I rode around and I looked and I said, gee, Quayla Cheese, gosh, this is more trouble than what I just got out of. You got 9 look at yourself. You got to wear that, whether you like it or not. You got to do things. You got to get up and go through all kinds of changes, whether you want to or not, doesn't matter. Your whole life is put in your paycheck. You couldn't pay me all the money in the world to do something I don't want to do. If I'm shoving the barn and you want me to go Jeff Kevin Rumsbaum, I say, no, I'm doing something right here. I'm helping this blind man. I feel better in doing what I want to do. I did not break the law. Jesus Christ told you that 2,000 years ago. You don't understand me. That's your trouble. It's not my fault because you don't understand me. I don't understand you either. But I don't spend my whole life trying to put the blame over on you because my spirit didn't like. Or because something didn't work right. What do you want to call me a murderer for? I've never killed anyone. I don't need to kill anyone. I think it. I have it here. I don't need to live in this physical realm. I walk around in the physical realm, and I put on the faces, and I talk, and I play, and I yeah. It's this big act, man. In the spiritual world is where I live. I exist in places you never even dreamed of. You talk about, you know, this little physical realm you live in, guilty and is he in sin? How's your corpse guilty? How many people do you think you've hung on the ventilators and the nut wards and forced medication on them? You see what I'm saying? You don't have any idea what the hell's going on. If you knew what the hell was going on in your own system, then you'd say, now I see what's creating this. Society's creating this. Society's saying, we want these Rambos. We want these killers. Oh, wow, man. Look at that dude there. You got little kids looking in the book and where they selling them. And it's, oh, yeah, Sears and Roebuck. Rambo from 12 to 15. Kai Karate from age 5 to 17. When you got all your kids out here doing these crazy things, now you want to come and say, Charlie Manson's the father of our country. We're convicting you for being Jesus Christ. We're convicting you for being the devil. We're convicting you for being responsible for our actions. I'm not responsible for anyone's actions but my own actions. And my whole life I've fertilized the grocery stores, sold some nickels and dimes, busted open a stamp machine, stole a few automobiles, and cashed a couple checks. I'm a petty cop. I've been with prostitutes and bums and winos and all my life. This street is my world. I don't pretend to go uptown and be anything fancy. I can,
but I find more real in the world that I make than I do the tinsel. And the real world is the one I have to deal with every day. Believe me, if I started murdering people, there'd be none of you left. I'm not a phone. I don't put on no air. I say what I think. You see what I'm saying?